tries to find that this mashup of my computational photography technique and the AI output that Dee Green was producing was really a nice match.
He's trained his robot to paint alongside of him. And I think he's a great example of someone who uses AI in multiple different processes.
You want to send you a screen, and so just having, not everybody has access to the
amount of compute, but in a game way, it's really important to have access to these, you know, these screen for your models.
It's not individual thing anymore, but it's all of this information modeling built into a single unit. And that represents the artist's ideas and their IP.
Cameron and I and Orlando could land on the surface of this planet and basically deploy scientific instruments to measure the ice, measure the water vapor, measure different things.
I think we're going to see a lot more recognition of artists' rights in the development of their models. We'll have opportunities for artists to opt in, to opt out. We'll be able to license model makers to use their work. They'll be able to create their own models using their work. They could then license the model for others to make work that looks like theirs, should you want to do that. I think it's just a whole new ecosystem that once artists are able to kind of collectively understand what their opportunities are, you'll find ways that you can have your voice and your vision as an artist transfer even bigger than you ever could have imagined as, you know, producer of single pieces.